Good morning, students. Welcome to the Monday's lecture. In this lecture, I am covering again social media marketing. I have received a lot of queries from the students. Students have asked me, sir, what exactly is the difference between social media marketing? Or first of all, they have said, what is the difference between social media and the normal media? Some students have asked me, is a regular Times of India website, can it be classified as social media? The specific question was, and the preface was, sir, you told us that social media is basically nothing but website and computer programs which allow people to communicate and share information. The medium is internet, and the requirement is that of either a computer or a mobile phone. This is correct. The student has further asked that in case of a website like India Today's website or Times of India's website, it is a website, it uses computer programs, it allows people to communicate, and it's a two-way communication because you can write your response to an article, you can forward the article, you can give your thumbs up or your thumbs down, you can choose to share that article. And you are interacting with that website using a computer or a mobile phone, and the connectivity medium is internet. So what is the difference between social media and a mainstream media? It's a very good question. That means you have been listening attentively to the audio PPTs. And it's a lacuna in the definition of social media. The biggest difference to my mind is that the content which is created in social media, the content is created by the users or the participants. So you have said India Today's website or Times of India's website. The content in a Hindustan Times website or a Hindu website or rediff.com is created by the company which owns that website. So in case of Times of India, Bennett Coleman is the owner of that website. Their editors have chosen what content they would like to share with the readers. Whereas in social media, the content is generated by the participants. So if you are a Twitterati, you're a person who has a Twitter handle, you can write whatever content you want to write. Of course, it should not be obscene, and you know, then because Twitter has closed down, the number of handles Twitter has closed down is amazing. They've closed to about a half a million or a quarter million Twitter handles they have closed down. Okay, because they say instead of downloads, they are looking at how to add value to the website by keeping the content readable, engaging and entertaining. So social media marketing is a form of internet marketing that involves creating and sharing content on social media in order to achieve your marketing and branding goals. Let me give you an example. You have come out with an amazing video on how to maximize return on investment, and you would like to share it with people. Or let us say you are a bank which is offering a rate of interest which is 2% more than the average rate of interest which is given by the other banks. What do you reach? You can reach through advertising. You can use FM radio or All India Radio to talk about it. You can use PR medium. But you can also promote this over various social media forums. Okay? There are sponsored content in social media, and they would insert, there is something called interest-based advertising in social media, interest-based advertising. So if you are on Facebook, and Facebook through its complex system of artificial intelligence, it is able to find out that you are a person who is interested in maximizing your wealth. So this advert or a sponsored page will appear on your web or on your Facebook. Okay, so this is highly targeted social media marketing. Social media marketing can include activities like posting text, image update, videos and other contents, which basically drive audience engagement. Engagement is the word. Engagement. And social media marketing can be paid, it can be unpaid, right? So if you want your tweet to reach, let us say, a certain amount of audience, the minimum payment starts with $50 on Twitter. So it will go like a sponsored tweet or an advertised tweet. And you can choose to put hashtags, you can choose to send this tweet by inserting the names of some of the influencers, and they can choose to retweet it. Okay, so this is social media marketing. The content is essentially generated by the participants themselves. So I hope you have understood the main difference between social media and the traditional media, which is called the mainstream media. In fact, all mainstream companies have Twitter handles. And a lot of people who read that newspaper, for example, follow their Twitter handle. Times of India has a Twitter handle, Hindu has a Twitter handle, Dainik Bhaskar has a Twitter handle, Amar Ujala has a Twitter handle, Rediff has a Twitter handle, NDTV has a Twitter handle. So the relationship is becoming highly symbiotic. On a television medium, on a medium like television, lot of social media companies are advertising. Google has been advertising, YouTube has been advertising, Facebook has been advertising on the electronic media. So one arm of media is leveraging the other arm of the media. Many times a question is asked, will social media eventually take over the mainstream media? That's never going to happen, because social media has limitation, right? Content creation is essentially a very specialized job. It's a very, very specialized area. So if you want to create news, a social media person cannot, the reliability factor will not be there. If you will just watch news on Facebook or on Twitter, somebody is posting a video. It could be a fake video, it could not be a fake video. It could be a video which is shot in some different location and people are attributing it to some other location, right? So content, intellectual content, content with depth, content with verified knowledge is done by specialized teams. And that is the job of the mainstream media. A NDTV Twitter handle can never replace NDTV itself. Mainstream media uses social media to promote the mainstream media. All my favorite columnist is Kumi Kapoor. She writes for Indian Express. I don't take Indian Express hard copy. I read Times of India. But whenever I know, I follow Kumi Kapoor, I follow Indian Express. Whenever I know that on Indian Express there is a reference to her article, I will click on that and I'm able to read it on the electronic, on the computer or on my mobile phone. Similarly, Indian Express has a very good sports page. It covers, and its commentary on sports is something which I appreciate very, very much. So I would like all the time to read Suppose I am interested in English Premier League and I am following the Twitter handle of BBC Sports. So I will come to know what has happened in the English Premier League when I was sleeping. And I want to know it from the perspective of an Indian writer, I'll go to Indian Express. So social media can never ever replace mainstream media. On the contrary, mainstream media, which did not have very good financial muscle, is leveraging upon social media to reach more and more people. Content will remain the king. Can social media replace mainstream media as a preferred advertising vehicle? Yes, that can happen. It cannot replace completely, but will social media marketing overtake mainstream media marketing? That can happen. And that surely will happen. But for information, whether it is scientific information, news related, any discussions on ideology, any major debate, you cannot depend on social media alone. First of all, because there is a reliability factor, a credibility factor which is attached to the mainstream media. So this is my take on social media and versus or vis-a-vis the mainstream media. Let us now go to some of the most popular platforms of social media. Undoubtedly, the most popular is Facebook. Facebook, as at 2019, had 2.3 billion users worldwide, or 2375 million users. Facebook is a company which is headquartered in California. Out of all the 10 companies, 7 are headquartered in California. And Facebook started its journey in 2007. Mark Zuckerberg is the owner. I don't have to explain Facebook to you. Facebook remains the preferred, one of the most liked social platforms. YouTube follows next. YouTube is owned by Google. Google bought YouTube in 2006. It has 2 billion active subscribers. Once again, headquartered in California, and it started in year 2005. WhatsApp. Facebook bought WhatsApp in 2014. WhatsApp again is headquartered in California, and it has 1.6 billion subscribers. Why is WhatsApp a social media? I will explain to you in great detail again, but not on this slide. Facebook Messenger, again headquartered in California, USA, it has 1.3 billion users. Year of start, 2011. 1 billion is how many crores? 100 crores. WeChat, which is headquartered in Shenzhen, China, it is owned by Tencent Holding. It has 1.12 billion active users worldwide. Now your favorite, Instagram. Instagram was acquired by Facebook in 2012. So you see the strength of Facebook, the dominance of Facebook. It is headquartered in California, again about 1 billion worldwide. Another Chinese company, QQ, it has got less than 1 billion, 823 million subscribers. It is based out of China. It is owned by Tencent Holding. After that comes Qzone, which has 572 million subscribers, again in China. TikTok. We will have a special session on TikTok. TikTok is headquartered in Shanghai, China. It is owned by ByteDance and Sinacorp. Alibaba has 32% share in this. After that, Sina Weibo. It has 465 million subscribers. It is based out of Beijing, China. It was started in 2009. And last but not the least, my favorite website, Twitter. Twitter has 330 million, 10 lakh crore, 10 crore, 33 crore users worldwide. It is also based out of California. Can you imagine? I have seen their headquarters. You can take a car and you can go around and see their headquarters in half a day. It is founded by Jack Dorsey and three others. So you see, Facebook owns 2.3 billion subscribers and then 1.6. So that makes it almost 4 billion. And then Messenger 1.3 or 5.3 billion. And then you add Instagram 6.3 billion. 630 crore. 1 billion is 100 crore. 630 crore active subscribers. In UK, there is a campaign that if so much dominance should be allowed or not. This is the power of social media. I hope you have liked this presentation. Wait for my next presentation, which I'll upload today. Thank you.